Good morning, students. Welcome you all to this session. Today's class, we are going to continue exercise 6.1. You can take page number 121, children, and you can refer the questions from your textbook. Okay?
I hope you all have taken page number 121. And this is your fifth question. Following is the list of temperatures of 5 places in India. See, they have given 5 places in India and their temperatures. Okay, list of temperature is given for 5 places in India on a particular day of the year. Okay, on particular day, Siachen has this much temperature, Shimla, Ahmedabad, Delhi, Srinagar. So for all these 5 places, they have given the temperature in wordings like 10 degrees Celsius below 0 degrees Celsius, 2 degrees Celsius below 0 degrees Celsius, 30 degrees Celsius above 0 degrees Celsius, 20 degrees Celsius above 0 degrees Celsius, 5 degrees Celsius below 0 degrees Celsius. I already told when I am teaching the integers are mainly used in temperatures. Okay, when you are dealing with the temperature, you will use this integers most probably. Okay, next, now a subdivision, write the temperature of these places in the form of integers in the blank column. See, here only in the wordings they have given, we are going to write these temperatures in integers here. If it is below, you will write negative integer, above you will write it as positive integer. So these temperatures, we are going to write it in this blank box, blank space, in terms of integer. So Siachen, what is the temperature? 10 degrees Celsius below 0 degrees Celsius. So minus 10 degrees Celsius. Because below degree na, you will write minus 10 degrees Celsius. Shimla, 2 degrees Celsius below 0 degrees Celsius. Minus 2 degrees Celsius. Because minus, below means minus. Ahmedabad, 30 degrees Celsius above. Above? Plus 30 degrees Celsius. Above 0 degrees Celsius. Okay, that's why I am plus 30 degrees Celsius. Delhi, 20 degrees Celsius above 0 degrees Celsius. Plus 20 degrees Celsius. Srinagar, 5 degrees Celsius below 0 degrees Celsius. So, minus 5 degrees Celsius. So we have completed our first question. Write the temperature of these places in the form of integers in the blank column. So we have completed the first subdivision. B. Following is the number line representing the temperature in degree Celsius. This is what your number line, children. That too, this number line is representing the temperature of that places. So what we have to do, plot the name of the cities against its temperature. So likewise, we are going to plot this. Okay, what is the Siachen's temperature? Minus 10 degrees Celsius. So where is the minus 10 degree will come? Here. Okay, at the same place you can put one arrow mark, Siachen. Likewise, you have to plot it. Siachen, first place have you plotted? Yes. Next, Shimla, minus 2 degrees Celsius. Where does this minus 2 will come? Here. 0, minus 1, minus 2. Listen. So this is what your minus 2. So what is the place? Shimla. Next. Ahmedabad, plus 30 degrees Celsius. Where this plus 30 will come? In the right side. So this is your Ahmedabad. Okay, next, Delhi, plus 20 degrees Celsius, plus 20 will be in right side, Delhi. Okay, next, Srinagar, minus 5 degrees Celsius. Where does this minus 5 will come? In the left side. Minus 5 is here. So what is the place? Srinagar. So this is how you should plot it. So they have given the number line. In that number line, we are going to plot it. Okay. Which is the coolest place? I already told you. when it is in a positive integers, that place is very hot. Okay, but when it is in the minus degree, that place is very cool. So in minus, which is very small, minus 10. So Siachen is the coolest place. So you can write Siachen is the coolest place. Okay, in minus degree, which is very small, that is your coolest place. Okay, next. Write the name of the places where temperature are above 10 degree Celsius. Above 10 degree means it is positive side, above, positive direction. So what are the places which is above 10 degree Celsius? Delhi and Ahmedabad. So shall I write here? Delhi and Ahmedabad are the two places where temperature is above. Above means right side. Right side of 10 degree is 20 and 30 degree, which is Delhi and Ahmedabad. Understood? Next is your sixth question. What is the question, children? In each of the following pairs, which number is to the right of the other on the number line? Okay, there are given two numbers, which means they have given a pair of numbers. In that two numbers, which is written on the right side of the number line? So just we'll draw one rough number line. Okay, 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9. Okay. See, we have just given a rough number line. This number line, just we can consider it. 2, where the 2 will be here. 9 will be here. So, which is on the right side? 9. So, you can circle this 9. Okay, you can write it in the textbook itself, no problem. Okay, next, minus 3, minus 8. Minus 3, minus 8. In these two, which is on the right side? Minus 3. Okay, next, 0, minus 1. 0, minus 1. So, which is on the right side? 0. Okay, listen children. And one more, another way I'll say you, instead of drawing this number line, we can itself directly write it. In this, which number is greater, that will be on the right side. So 2 and 9, which is greater? 9. So 9 will be in the right side. Minus 3, minus 8. In this, which is greater? Minus 3. So I'll circle it. 0 and minus 1. Always 0 is greater than the negative number. So 0 will be in the right side. This is how you should predict the values which is given on the right side. Understood? And remaining 3 subdivision is your homework. Okay? Next is your 7th question. You can see the 7th question, children. Write all the integers between the given pairs. Okay? See, there are given pair, 0 and minus 7 is given. We have to write the integers between these two. So, you should not write 0, you should not write minus 7. In between those two numbers, what are all numbers is there, that you should write. And we have to arrange that number in increasing order. Increasing order means we have to arrange them in ascending order. Okay, first I'll write the integers between 0 and minus 7. 0 and minus 7 means is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6. Okay, and you can write, okay, and minus 6. Minus 1, minus 2, because there I should not include 0. So the next is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5 and minus 6. You should not write minus 7. So in this increasing order, how you will write, children? From small to big. So in this numbers, which is smallest? Minus 6. Then minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1. So in this, minus 6 is very small. Then minus 5, minus 4,
even though the number is larger, I told you when it is a minus sign, you will write the number with larger value is the smallest. So this is the smallest, then greatest, greatest, and then minus 1 is the greatest of all. Understood? So this is how you should write the integers. Next here, integers between minus 4 and 4 are, so here also you should write R, okay. What are the integers between minus 4 and 4? Minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, that's all, no? Minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. So, in this increasing order, so which is increasing order here? This is the smallest, this is greatest. So, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. It is in increasing order. So, this is very small. Negative numbers will be written first because negative numbers are very small when compared to your positive numbers. So, this is what your integers between minus 4 and 4. Understood? Next is your 8th question. 8A, write 4 negative integers greater than minus 2, minus 20. We are going to write the 4 negative integer, okay. That too greater than minus 2. Greater than means what? Actually, this minus 20 will be smaller that time. So, we have to write the greater numbers. Greater number, it does not means that minus 21, minus 22. It is actually lesser than minus 20. So, we are going to write the negative integers greater than minus 20 are minus 19, minus 18, minus 17 and minus 16. So these are all the 4 negative integers which is greater than minus 20. Is it? This is greater, right? When compared to minus 20, this number is greater. Okay, understood? This is very easy, but don't get confused in small things. Even the number is smaller than this, since we have minus sign, this is greater than this number. Next, write 4 integers less than minus 10. We are going to write 4 integers less than minus 10. 4 integers less than minus 10 are, what are all 4 integers you will write? Minus 11, minus 12, minus 13 and minus 14. Is it? When compared to minus 10, minus 11, minus 12, minus 13 and minus 14 are very small. That's why I have written the answer. Understood? It is very, very easy. Next is your 9th question, children. See this. See the cursor. Minus 8 is to the right of minus 10 on a number line. We have to write the true or false for this question. Okay. Always see, minus 8 is to the right of minus 10 on a number line. Just consider one number line. In that, minus 8, where it will come? To the right side. After that only minus 9. After that only minus 10. So, right side of minus 10, the minus 8 will be there. So, A option is true. Okay, you can itself draw a number line and check it. Okay, so minus 8 is right to the minus 10. So, A option is true. B option, minus 100 is right of minus 50. Is it correct? Actually, minus 800 is less than minus 50. Always greater values only will be in right side, right? But here they are saying minus 100 is right side. So, B option is false. Okay, next, C option. C question, smallest negative integer is minus 1. Is it? No, because minus 2 is less than minus 1, minus 3 is less than minus 1. So the greatest negative integer is actually minus 1. Okay, so this is the C option, question is false. Okay, next D option, minus 26 is greater than minus 25. Is it? No, minus 25 is actually greater than minus 26. So D option is also false. So A option is true, B option false, C option false, D option false. Understood? You can simply draw one number line and you can answer these questions. Okay? Next is your 10th question. Okay children, 10th question we are going to deal with. What is the 10th question? Draw a number line and answer the following. We are going to draw the number line and we are going to answer these questions. What is the A option? Which number will we reach if we move 4 numbers to the right of minus 2? They are asking, when we move right side of minus 2 4 steps, what number you will reach? Okay, first we can draw one number line and we can identify the question. Okay, first we should draw one number line, children. Just draw it in pencil and scale. Okay, so this is what your number line. Which number will we reach if we move 4 numbers to the right of minus 2? Now we are in minus 2, okay? We are in minus 2 and from minus 2, right side, this is your right side, right? If you move 4 numbers to the right of minus 2, what number you will get? Plus 2, okay? Because when I am in minus 2, I am moving 4 steps towards right side, the number I am getting is plus 2. So the number is plus 2. Okay, understood? From minus 2, 4 numbers I am jumping and I am reaching plus 2. Okay, the number which I am getting is what, children? Plus 2. So first of all, you should draw one number line and you should answer the questions that you should know. Okay, next is your B question. Okay, B, which number will we reach if we move 5 numbers to the left of 1? Okay, I'm actually in 1, children. I'm actually in the place of 1. I'm moving 5 numbers left side is what, this side, 5 numbers. From 1 I'm going to move 5 numbers. 1 2 3 4 5. So I am reaching which number? Minus 4. Okay, you can put the arrow mark like this. Which direction you are going? This direction, right? You can put the arrow mark like this. Here you are going left side, so arrow mark should be like this. Okay, you should indicate this arrow mark, then it is wrong. Okay, so we cannot identify which direction you are moving. Since you are moving left side, I am putting this arrow mark like this. So I am reaching the number minus 4. From 1, I am moving 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 steps. I am reaching minus 4. So the number is what? Minus 4. The number is minus 4. Understood? C is your next question, okay? What is this next question? If we are at minus 8. Now I am at minus 8. Okay. Now I am at minus 8 on the number line. In which direction should we move to reach minus 13? So from minus 8 I should reach minus 13. So which direction you should move? Left side. So what is the direction we are moving, children, now to reach that minus 13? Left side. Okay, direction is what? Left side. Understood? I am at minus 8. I want to reach minus 13. So I should move left side. Next. If we are at minus 6. I am at minus 6. Okay. On the number line. In which direction should we move to reach minus 1? I have to reach minus 1. So which direction I should move? Right side. So I should move right direction.
or right side I should move, okay? So I am at -6, I should reach -1, so I should move towards the right side. So this is what your last question, 10th question. Understood, children? Today's class we have discussed exercise 6.1 and I have given few problems as homework. I hope you all understood, children. Thank you.